A very warm welcome and good morning to our respected High Commissioner, Deputy High Commissioner, officers, colleagues, and our wonderful families. Happy 74th Independence Day to each of you here and to all those who were not able to attend. Today we are gathered to celebrate this auspicious occasion of India's independence. We like to celebrate our freedom each year with a lot of enthusiasm and joy, even though this year's celebration might be a little different, our pride is untouched. I would like to remind you all to please keep yourselves safe and respect those around you by remaining at a cautious distance from those who are outside of your household. Kindly do not take group photos other than with your own family. Each person to please stand when you come back in front of the stage on the orange marks on the ground. There are a couple of portable potties, restrooms at the back of the house. We will start today's program with the hoisting of the flag, followed by singing of the Indian National Anthem. The High Commissioner will then read the President's message to the nation. I would now like to call on the High Commissioner to hoist the flag, and if everyone could kindly direct your attention to our flag and remain at a safe distance from one another. High Commissioner will now read the President's message.
नमस्कार, आपको भारत के 74वें स्वतंत्रता दिवस की बहुत बहुत बधाई. ग्रीटिंग्स ऑन इंडियाज इंडिपेंडेंस डे. दिस इज़ अ स्पेशल हाइब्रिड फ्लैग होस्टिंग सेरेमनी. वी हैव सम मेंबर्स ऑफ द हाई कमीशन हियर एंड आई स्पेशली वांट टू वेलकम ऑल दोज वॉचिंग अस ऑन फेसबुक and all friends joining us either live or later. We would have liked to have you all physically present today, but we need to follow social distancing norms to protect everyone in these times of pandemic. Har baar ki tarah main Bharat ke Rashtrapati ka Rashtra ke naam sandesh uske kuch ansh Hindi aur phir Angrezi mein padhunga. As is the tradition, I will read some excerpts of our President's address to the nation in Hindi and also in English. Mere pyare deshvasiyon, namaskar. 74वें स्वतंत्रता दिवस की पूर्व संध्या पर देश विदेश में रह रहे भारत के सभी लोगों को बहुत बहुत बधाई और ढेर सारी शुभकामनाएं. 15 अगस्त को हम सब तिरंगे को लहराते हुए स्वाधीनता दिवस समारोह में भाग लेकर और देशभक्ति से भरे गीत सुनकर उत्साह से भर जाते हैं। हमारे युवाओं के लिए ये स्वाधीनता के गौरव को महसूस करने का दिन है। इस अवसर पर हम अपनी स्वाधीनता सेनानियों के बलिदान को कृतज्ञता से याद करते हैं। उनके बलिदान के बल पर ही हम सब आज एक स्वाधीन देश के निवासी हैं। हमारी स्वाधीनता संग्राम के आदर्शों की नींव पर ही आधुनिक भारत का निर्माण हो रहा है। हमारी दूरदर्शी राष्ट्रनायकों ने अपने विविध विचारों को राष्ट्रीयता का एक सूत्र में पिरोया था। उनकी साझा प्रतिबद्धता थी देश को दमनकारी विदेशी शासन से मुक्त कराना और भारत माता की संतानों के भविष्य को सुरक्षित करने की। उन्होंने अपने कार्यकलापों से आधुनिक राष्ट्र के रूप में भारत की पहचान को मूर्त रूप प्रदान दिया। हम सौभाग्यशाली हैं कि महात्मा गांधी हमारे स्वाधीनता आंदोलन के मार्गदर्शक रहे। उनके व्यक्तित्व में एक संत और राजनेता का जो समन्वय दिखाई देता है, वह भारत की मिट्टी में ही संभव था। सामाजिक संघर्ष, आर्थिक समस्याओं और जलवायु परिवर्तन के से परेशान आज की दुनिया गांधी जी की शिक्षाओं में समाधान पाती है। समानता और न्याय के लिए उनकी प्रतिबद्धता हमारे गणतंत्र का मूल मंत्र है। गांधी जी के बारे में युवा पीढ़ी की जिज्ञासा और उत्साह को देखकर मुझे अत्यंत खुशी होती है। डियर फेलो सिटीजन्स, द सेलिब्रेशंस ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस डे दिस ईयर विल बी रादर रिस्ट्रेंड। द रीजन इज ऑब्वियस, द होल वर्ल्ड कन्फ्रंट्स अ डेडली वायरस व्हिच हैज डिस्ट्रक्टेड ऑल एक्टिविटीज एंड टेकन अ ह्यूज टोल। इट हैज ऑल्टर्ड द वर्ल्ड वी लिव इन बिफोर द पेंडेमिक। It is very reassuring to note that the central government, while anticipating the tremendous challenge, responded effectively and well in time. For a country so vast and diverse with high population density, meeting this challenge requires superhuman effort. All state governments took measures in accordance with local circumstances. People also supported wholeheartedly. With our committed efforts, we have succeeded in containing the magnitude of the pandemic and saving a large number of lives. This is worth emulating by the wider world. The nation is indebted today to doctors, nurses, and other health workers who have been continuously on the forefront of our fight against this virus. Unfortunately, many of them have lost their lives battling the pandemic. They are our national heroes. All corona warriors deserve high praise. Dear fellow citizens, the poor and daily wage earners are the worst hit by the pandemic. In order to support them through this phase of crisis, virus containment efforts have been supplemented by welfare interventions. By introducing Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, the government has enabled crores of people to earn their livelihood and mitigate the impact of job loss, dislocation, and disruption caused by the pandemic. The needy are being given free food grains so that no family goes hungry. The largest free distribution program in the world, the largest free food distribution program in the world, has been extended till the end of November 2020 to provide succor to about 80 crore 800 million. People every month. In order to ensure that migratory ration cards holders get rations anywhere in the country, all states are being brought under the coverage of One Nation, One Ration Card scheme. Committed to taking care of our people stranded anywhere in the world, the government has brought back more than 10 lakh 1 million Indians under the Vande Bharat mission. Indian Railways has been operating train services in these challenging circumstances to facilitate travel and transportation of people and goods. Confident of our strengths, we reached out to help other countries in the fight against COVID-19. In response to calls from countries for supply of medicines, India has once again shown that it stands by the global community in times of distress. We have been at the forefront in evolving regional and global strategies for an effective response to the pandemic. The overwhelming support India got at the elections for the non-permanent seat of the United Nations Security Council is a testimony to the goodwill we enjoy internationally. It has been the tradition of India that we do not just live for ourselves, but work for the well-being of the entire world. India's self-reliance means being self-sufficient without alienating or creating distance from the world. It implies that India will continue to engage with the world economy while maintaining its identity. Dear fellow citizens, the world now realizes what our sages had said long ago. The global community is but one family, Vasudeva Kutumbukam. However, even while the world community needs to fight together against the greater challenge before humanity, some in our neighborhood try to carry out their misadventure of expansion. Our brave soldiers laid down their lives defending our borders. Those worthy sons of Bharat Mata lived and died for national pride. The entire nation salutes the martyrs of Galwan Valley. Every Indian feels grateful to their family members. Their bravery in combat has demonstrated that while we believe in peace, we are also capable of giving a befitting response to any attempt of aggression. We are proud of the members of our armed forces, paramilitary forces, and police personnel who protect the borders and ensure our internal security. I believe that in the fight against COVID-19, life and livelihood are both essential. We have looked at the current crisis as an opportunity to initiate reforms to revitalize the economy for the benefit of all, especially farmers and small entrepreneurs. Landmark reforms have been introduced in the agriculture sector. Now, farmers can have barrier-free trade and get the best price for their produce anywhere in the country. The Essential Commodities Act has been amended to remove certain regulatory restrictions on farmers. This will help raise farmers' income. We have learned some tough lessons in the year 2020. The invisible virus has demolished the illusion that the human being is the master of nature. I believe it is still not too late for humanity to correct its course and live in harmony with nature. The pandemic, like climate change, has awakened the global community to our shared destiny. In my view, human-centric collaboration is more important than economy-centric inclusion in the present context. The greater this change, the better it will be for humanity. The 21st century should be remembered as the century when humanity put aside differences and collaborated to save the planet. The second lesson is that we are all equal before Mother Nature, and we primarily depend on our fellow residents for survival and growth. Coronavirus does not recognize any artificial divisions created by human society. This reinforces the belief that we need to rise above all man-made differences, prejudices, and barriers. Compassion and mutual help have been adopted as basic values by the people of India. We need to further strengthen this virtue in our conduct. Only then can we create a future which is better for all of us. The third lesson is about augmenting health infrastructure. Public hospitals and laboratories have been leading the fight against COVID-19. Public health services have helped the poor cope with the pandemic. In view of this, public health infrastructure needs to be expanded and strengthened. The fourth lesson relates to science and technology. The pandemic has highlighted the need to accelerate developments in countries for supply of medicines. India has once again shown that it stands by the global community. During the lockdown and subsequent unlocking information and communication technology has emerged as an effective tool for governance, education, business, office work, and social connect. It has helped meet the twin objectives of saving lives and resumption of activities. With a view to providing futuristic education to our children and youth, the central government has decided to implement the National Education Policy. I'm confident that with the implementation of this policy, a new quality education system will be developed, and this will transform the future challenges into opportunities, paving the way for a new India. Our youth will be able to freely choose their subjects according to their interests and talents. They would have an opportunity to realize their potential. Our future generations will not only be able to get employment of the strength of such abilities, but will also create employment opportunities for others. My dear fellow citizens, only 10 days ago, construction of the temple at Sri Ram Janmabhoomi began in Ayodhya. It was indeed a moment of pride for all. People of the country maintained restraint and patience for a long time and reposed unflinching trust in the judicial system. The issue of Ram Janmabhoomi was resolved through a judicial process. All concerned parties and the people respectfully accepted the verdict of the Supreme Court and displayed before the world the Indian ethos of peace, non-violence, love and harmony. I congratulate all fellow citizens for their commendable conduct. When India won freedom, many predicted that our experiment with democracy will not last long. They saw our ancient traditions and rich diversity as hurdles in democratization of our polity. But we have always nurtured them as our strengths that make the largest democracy in the world so vibrant. India has to continue playing its leading role for the betterment of humanity. The patience and wisdom being demonstrated by all of you in coping with the pandemic has been appreciated all over the world. I'm confident that you will continue to maintain caution and act responsibly. We have a lot to offer to the global community, especially for intellectual and spiritual enrichment and promotion of world peace. With this spirit, I offer a prayer for the well-being of one and all. Sarve bhavantu sukhina, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani paschantu, ma kadish dukhbhag bhave. That means, may all be happy, may all be free from illness, may all see what is auspicious, may no one come to grief. This message of this prayer for universal well-being is India's unique gift to humanity. I once again congratulate you on the eve of the 74th Independence Day. I wish you good health and a bright future. Thank you. Jai Hind. Thank you for your patience. That was the excerpts from the President's address to the nation last night. And the complete text of this address is available on our website and social media, both in Hindi and English. Prime Minister Modi also spoke from the ramparts of the Red Fort this morning. His was a call for a proud, confident, self-reliant, Atmanirbhar India. This will be an India challenging terrorism and expansionism as it moves to a new digital future. This speech is also available on social media. For all friends watching us on Facebook, I want to thank you for being with us. I also want to say we are very proud of the unique Indo-Canadian community, which is today 1.6 million strong. We also have in Canada over 700,000 people with Indian passports. That includes more than 200,000 students. We are proud of the achievements of our Indo-Canadian community, which has provided Canada with 22 members of parliament, 4 ministers in the current government. They are role models for all of us. It has also provided strong leadership in business, technology, academics, culture. The Indo-Canadian strategic partnership is getting stronger by the day, propelled by a deepening economic relationship. the Indo-Canadian community has a very strong role in fostering these ties. So please join us all over Canada today in celebrating this very special occasion. I once again wish you a very happy Independence Day and thank you for joining this celebration. Thank you very much.
As it's known, as it's known, music is the language of the soul. We will now enjoy performances of patriotic songs by Girinandani and Hanshu, daughters of the High Commission family.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. Hello. Mic check. Mic check. Before we start, Happy Independence Day to respected High Commissioner Sir, respected High Commissioner Madam, and all the guests. आज हम आपके समक्ष उपाध्याय सिस्टर्स तीन पेट्रियोटिक सॉन्ग्स गाएंगे।
Thank you.
Thank you, girls. That was wonderful. Last but not the least, snacks this year will be served differently in order to keep everyone safe. You will each get a takeaway with goodies to enjoy. Thank you all for being here and sharing this auspicious day with us. Have a wonderful weekend. And you can now go and help yourself to some snacks. Thank you.